Idea is defined as the subset of social intelligence that involves the ability to monitor one's own and others' feelings and emotions, to discriminate among them, and to use this information to guide one's thinking and action. It was the first formal theory of emotional intelligence. Daniel Goleman, who popularized EI, defined it simply as being about learning to manage your personality. We in leadership define emotional intelligence as: emotional intelligence allows us to think more creatively and to use our emotions as a tool to help solve problems. It gives us the ability to allow our emotions to inform our intellect and power our achievements. John Knight, founder of Leadership Global. Emotion intelligence enables individuals to better manage their personalities, behaviors, and innate skills towards maximizing personal performance and enabling the improved performance of others. These are important life skills for us, but within organizations, they have increasing impact the more senior the leader. Research projects in many organizations have proven that emotionally intelligent people perform better and are more successful. Daniel Goleman research showed that success at work is 80% dependent on emotional intelligence, only 20% on IQ. We believe that the use of EQ as an acronym of emotional intelligence, as used in some models, is misleading and being referred to as emotional quotient as a comparison to IQ, which is intelligent quotient, suggests a fixed measurement that cannot be changed. IQ is based on genetics and once achieved till a certain age cannot be majorly improved. Emotional intelligence, on the other hand, is based on observable behavior, which are compared to a desired behavior in a non-judgmental way. We can enhance emotional intelligence thanks to neuroplasticity throughout our lives and is hence not a fixed number as is IQ. EI is broken down into four competencies: self-awareness, self-management, social awareness, and relationship management. Each of the competencies is made up of several EI capabilities. There are a total of 19 EI capabilities. Based on our leadership development interventions carried out in India and the data analysis of leaders in India published by Routledge in a white paper about leadership in India by me, we found that the strengths were organizational awareness, transparency, service orientation, emotional self-control, and optimism. The EI capabilities needing development were empathy, developing others, conflict management, change catalyst, and inspirational leadership. Empathy is by far the EI capability that is most commonly in need of development. 62% of all leaders, regardless of sex, country, or sector. Often men just do not get empathy unless they are taken on a journey of discovery. And women often confuse it with sympathy. Developing others is the second most common area for improvement. The problem here is that most leaders just do not realize that one of their key tasks is to develop the people around them, especially those reporting directly to them. A simple example. What do most of us do when someone comes and asks us for a decision or for advice? We give them the answer. What do they learn from this? In a development role, the leader should not answer the question, but instead pose one such as, what would you have done if I was not here? Or, what is your opinion? This kind of open questions provide both challenge and support at the same time, providing a platform for learning. Conflict management is another area where many leaders are not very effective. The issue is that they are not aired early enough. We tend to put things off until they become more serious. And when things do get serious, we are likely to get emotional about them. And so often, our emotions hijack us. Perhaps surprisingly, change catalyst is the fourth most common development area. We instinctively expect leaders to be the drivers of change, but often they are the ones preferring the status quo. Why change something that got them to the top? Fifth is inspirational leadership. The key barriers we came across are that leaders did not involve their people in developing the vision or the behavior, and values did not match the words they used.